Hello, and thanks for tuning in. I am Stephen Carlini, Vice President of Innovation and Data Centers for Schneider Electric, here to discuss this top-of-mind topic for IT and OT integration. We're going to talk about an overview of cybersecurity best practices for edge computing. We will have an expert here, Daniel Paillet, who is the author of recently released white paper number 12. So, in the old days, we used to see cyber hackers in movies physically break into highly secure data centers that had IP identification or facial recognition. Then they would plug an Ethernet cable or thumb drive into a server and steal the names of secret agents or get bank account information and transfer millions of dollars. Today's hackers are more sophisticated. They look for easier ways into secure networks. Sometimes they don't even have to leave the couch in the basement of their mother's house. The world is becoming more and more automated. Industrial automation through Industry 4.0 is bringing new levels of productivity and efficiency to manufacturing, to pipeline management, to wastewater and mining, for example. So hundreds and thousands of IoT sensors are being deployed, and many applications are leveraging edge computing, which brings latency-free real-time processing right there on site, right on your site. So IT and OT convergence is happening, but it's not all fun and games. Each new edge computing data center with IoT sensors exponentially broadens the possible cyber attack surface. Recently, an old smart water treatment facility in Florida had a significant cyber breach. An attacker used remote access to the system to change the level of sodium hydroxide, more commonly known as lye, in the water from 100 parts per million to 11,100 parts per million. The attacker accessed the water treatment plant's SCADA controls via TeamViewer, which is software to manage the water treatment site remotely. TeamViewer was installed on the edge data center on site at the water treatment plant, and there was no firewall. So today, welcome one of the foremost experts in cybersecurity, Daniel Paillet, and author of Schneider Electric's white paper number 12, an overview of cybersecurity best practices for edge computing. So Daniel, can you tell us, who is responsible for cybersecurity at the edge?
Well, that can go from the end user or the operator all the way up to the corporate executive. So I would say edge computing is responsible of the entire organization. Organization has to have the correct processes, the policies, and the guidelines to make their employees aware. There should also be proper training on cybersecurity, as well as just constant education of the people and the personnel, and to be very, very pay due diligence on what they're doing on a day-to-day activity. So I would say it's everyone's responsibility.
So everyone, we're all in this together. All right. So are distributed edge computer deployments more challenging from a cyber perspective than maybe centralized sites?
Well, I think so, because they are distributed. You have devices all over the place doing all kinds of different functions and functionality. You have more things to look at, more things to see. You have these devices that are doing all kinds of different things and then sending data to a central location. So to me, there's more challenge in a distributed system because you just have so much more. So to me, the distributed is more of a challenge.
Interesting. So with the growing trend towards edge, this presents a problem. So edge data centers are at the edge of the network. So let's talk secure network design. Can't I just put a firewall on my edge data center and be done with it?
You could, but a firewall only does one thing, right? It's part of this concept of a defense in depth. You can have a firewall that's up there protecting, but if any kind of, let's say, a zero-day attack comes along and the firewall's not aware of what that signature is, then your firewall pretty much at that point becomes useless. So you want to take an approach of a multi-layered defense or defense in depth, where you have different devices and different processes to support the security, because the idea is as one layer fails, another one should pick it up. So, yeah, I wouldn't rely solely on a firewall. I would definitely look at a defense in depth model.
Interesting. So it's not simple. Not simple at all. Okay. So what are there tools that are available to watch?
There's quite a few tools out there. You can start, if you have a security operations center, a SOC, for example. That's where you have 7x24 personnel monitoring your environment. Some of the tools would be a SIM, Security Incident Event Manager. You could also have an intrusion detection system. You can have network segmentation, correct access control layers placed into your environment, and of course the firewalls as well. So there's all kinds of tools you can use, and those are just some that I mentioned in this discussion.
Interesting. Yeah, in the past I've heard you talk about data diodes. Can you explain, you know, what they are and how they could protect your network at the edge?
Well, the data diode is a pretty simple idea. It's simple in conception, but can be very difficult to implement because of the nature of a data diode. So a data diode allows traffic to go only one way, and it basically protects at the layer one, right, at the hardware layer. So there's nothing to hack. The traffic is allowed to go one way and one way only, so that way no one can come back at you. For example, a firewall, you can break through a firewall, right? Because it will respond. Data diode will not. So a data diode would be a great place to put. Let's say if you have a security system or some very, very critical systems on the edge, you can put your data diode in front of these critical systems and thereby allowing traffic to go out one way. So it's a great appliance, but you have to really have a good strategy and a good, clear understanding of how to implement the data diode.
Okay. Let's move on to operations and maintenance. Is there a safe way to do patch management?
Yeah, if you're looking at OT, operation technology, where there's a lot of embedded devices, you have to be very careful at patch management. The last thing you want to do is break something. And operators are a little touchy with that stuff, right? Because when you're applying these patches, it can affect how they're monitoring things and seeing things. So when you do patch management, just be very careful. Understand what your devices are. Hopefully they have a good change management program and you have a way to fall back if there's a problem with a patch update. But before you do the patch update, test the patches, make sure that it doesn't break anything. So I'd say proceed with caution. Test it and validate that you're not going to break something before you apply that patch.
Yeah, sounds like good advice. So what about vulnerability management and penetration testing? Do you recommend those?
I do, but I would also, like we previously talked about in patch management, you have to proceed with caution. Vulnerability management, you start running a scan, you can take systems down. That's why you probably want to implement more of a passive approach of scanning. You want to make sure that, like before, you don't want to take things down, so proceed with caution. Definitely, you should have a good program of patch management, vulnerability management, as well as penetration testing. When you do penetration testing, make sure your people know what they're doing, because you can take a system down. And in the OT world, that can be very critical, right? Because in the OT world, we're all about safety and reliability. And we want to make sure we don't endanger safety and we don't also impair the reliability of devices when we do these types of operations.
Yeah, sounds like good advice. So in some systems, we have people as the weak link. How about here at the edge? Are people the weak link at the edge?
People are always going to be the weak link. As we previously discussed, education is a very important thing. And the education doesn't just have one course. You should have programs where you're constantly, you know, reminding people. For example, at the edge, social engineering. You'd want to make sure that people just don't let anyone into the environment. So people will always be the weakest link, and they're the ones that you have to really have a good education program, keep people up to date on best practices, you know, and that's all organizations can do now is just educate your people, maintain them, you know, make sure their backgrounds are validated and they're clear, and that's where I would start.
Very interesting indeed. So thank you, Daniel, for that excellent insight. It's clear that IT and OT organizations need to cooperate and come together on cybersecurity for edge applications. There's lots of great topics you discussed today on the network design side, on the operations and maintenance side. So the people, if you want a deeper understanding, we encourage you to read white paper number 12, an overview of cybersecurity best practices for edge computing. Thanks and have a great day.